Good morning, children. How are you all? I think today you are very well. Yes? No doubt at all. You are very well. Dear children, my name is S.K. Mira Hussain, School Assistant English, JPHS Chintakani, Khammam District. Chintakani Mandal. And already I took 10th and 9th classes. And then today, dear children, now we are going to discuss 9th class 6th unit A reading. 9th class 6th unit A reading. A long walk to freedom. A long walk to freedom. Actually, it's an interesting and wonderful lesson. And in this A reading, before we enter into the lesson, let us look at the pictures for picture reading. I will ask a few questions and then we have to give the answers. Dear children, now I am going to share the screen. I am going to share the screen of pictures of picture. Yes. Now you have to look at the screen. Here the picture talks with us. If you have textbook, you will open and look at page number 108. My dear children, you have to look at page number 108. Look at the following pictures and let's discuss the questions here. The first question I will ask you, look at the picture. Who are the persons? Who are the persons in the picture? Before that, how many persons are there? Yes, there are two persons in the pictures. Who are they? Think and say, my dear children. Think and say. Yes, yes. The first person is M.K. Gandhi, Mahatma Gandhi. And second one is, remember and say, yes, exactly. The second person is Nelson Mandela. The second person is Nelson Mandela. Okay, who are they? Already there are two persons, M.K. Gandhi and Nelson Mandela. And now, second question I will ask you, my dears. Who are they? Yes, who are they? They are national leaders. They are national leaders. World class, they are national leaders. World class leaders. World class leaders. And what do you know? What do you know about the great two persons in the pictures? First one is M.K. Gandhi and second one is Nelson Mandela. Yes, here the pictures here are of Mahatma Gandhi and Nelson Mandela. There are two persons. And then they sacrificed their lives, not for their family, for country. That is their unique character. Here, the two persons sacrificed their lives for their countries. They exhibited excellent human qualities. They exhibited excellent human qualities in their movements. And they remain forever and ever as models for leadership and humanity. Really, my dears, yeah, two persons will remain forever and ever because they sacrifice their lives for their country and they are the role model for leadership and humanity. Okay, yes, next question. Observe the picture carefully. What similarities do you find in their lives? Are there any same qualities? Similarities means same qualities. Do you find out? Yes, try to say. Mahatma Gandhi and Nelson Mandela have a lot of similarities in their lives. Here, they have more number of similarities. And for example, first, both are colored. Both are colored. Both are colored people. Mahatma Gandhi and Nelson Mandela are both are colored people. But suffered at the hands of the whites. Yes, as they are black, they are suffered in the hands of whiteies. Do you know the discrimination between white and black? Yes, I think you have got an idea. Both of them fought for their countries. Here, M.K. Gandhi and Nelson Mandela. Both of them fought for their country. They sacrificed their personal lives for their movement. Fully they sacrificed their personal lives for their country. Both of them spent a lot of time in jails. Other similarity. Both of them, Mahatma Gandhi and Nelson Mandela, they spent a lot of time in jails. People regard both of them as their greatest leaders. Yes, now also they will remain as the greatest leader forever and ever in the minds of people. So, dear children, while we look at this picture, easily we will remain all these personality features and the greatness of the world-class leaders and their characters and their idealism, all we will get. So, dear children, this is about this picture. While we talked about this picture, easily we will recollect about the nation, national freedoms and the national movements and the fight for the freedom. All these words will recollect in our minds. Okay, dear children. So, in this context, now we are going to read. Now we are going to read from 6th unit, air reading, A Long Walk to Freedom. A Long Walk to Freedom. So, before that, it's an autobiography. It's an autobiography. Do you know? What do you mean autobiography? Here? Dear children, do you know? What do you mean autobiography? A biography which is written themselves, himself, herself. So here, Nelson Mandela wrote an autobiography of Long Walk to Freedom. So here, our writer is Nelson Mandela. So let's know a few details about this Nelson Mandela. Here, Nelson Mandela already we discussed about him. I'm going to share the introduction about the author. Yes, it's very clear. Nelson Mandela was born on July 18, 1918. Yeah, he was born on July 18, 1918. Nelson Mandela was the first South African president to be elected in a fully representative democratic election. He's the first person who was elected as a representative democratic election. Trained as an attorney, he helped from the Youth League of the African National Congress. Here, ANC. Here, ANC stands for African National Congress in 1944. In 1961, he abandoned peaceful protest and became head of the ANC's new military wing. He conducted, he involved in that peaceful protest, and he became head of ANC new military wing, and he was sentenced to life imprisonment in 1964. My dears, here Nelson Mandela was sentenced to life imprisonment in 1964. Mandela came to symbolize black political aspirations and was named head of the ANC after he released on February 11, 1990. Was released on February 11, 1990. He and F.W. de Klerk shared the Nobel Peace Prize for negotiating South Africa's peaceful transition to multiracial democracy. Here, he got with the person F.W. de Klerk. Okay, after the ANC victory in the April 1994 elections, Mandela worked to ease racial tensions, vote for foreign investment, and provide services to the victims of apartheid. Children, do you know the word apartheid? Yes, apartheid is nothing but the racial discrimination between whites and blackies. Here, the racial discrimination between white and blacky means the struggle of class of two people. Apartheid, discrimination of color, So here, dear children, this is about Nelson Mandela, and he's a great writer and a national leader and a freedom fighter. Now, let's move to the text. Dear children, now let's move to the text, A Long Walk to Freedom. A Long Walk to Freedom. If you have textbook, you will open and look at 109. Children, if you have textbook, you will open and look at page number 109. I'm going to share the screen of that text. Yes, dear children, here. The page number, yes, here, the page number 109. Let's look at page number 109 carefully. A Long Walk to Freedom. In life, every man has two obligations. In life, for every man, they have two obligations. Here, first, what do you mean obligation? Yes, obligation is nothing but responsibility or duty. What? Responsibility or duty. Responsibility or duty. So here, for every person in our life, we have two obligations. What are they? Obligations to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children. Here, first obligation is to his family. In family members, to his parents, to his wife, and to his children. And he has an obligation to his people. Yes. The second obligation is to his people, means to the society. Means to his community and his country. So, dear children, it's very clear. In our life, there are two obligations for every person. One is to his family, and another is to his country. Is it clear? Yes. In a civil and human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclinations and abilities. Yes, every person has, but we will fulfill according to our ability and according to our inclinations. Here, inclination means a feeling that makes a person to do something. Yes, inclination towards that doing of that work. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both of those obligations. Here, that's normally saying, it's very hard. It's very hard to fulfill two obligations of my life, particularly towards his society. Because as he is black, here there is a racial discrimination with whiteies. That is called apartheid. Yes. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was published and isolated. Yes, he was isolated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family. Yeah, if a person is striving hard to do service to the society, then he has to ripe out from the family. He has to come out from the family to do service for the society. And his home, and was forced to live a life apart, a twilight existence of secrecy and rebellion. Here, twilight means which is uncertainty, which is indicating uncertain, that is common. That is common as a part of secrecy and rebellion. I didn't in the beginning choose to place my people above my family, but in attempting to serve my people, I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son and as a brother and as a father and a husband. Here, who refers I? Yes, Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela. He is saying, he found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligations as a son, as a brother, and as a father, and a husband. I was not born with a hunger to be free. Yes, he is saying. Mandela is saying, I was not born with a hunger to be free. I was born free, free. Yeah, Nelson Mandela was born free, free. In every way, he was born free, free. That I could know. Free to run in the fields near my mother's hut. Here, I think those are nothing but his childhood days. How Mandela did spend his childhood days. How? Free to run in the fields. He is very free to run in the fields. Near my mother's hut, means his mother's hut. Free to swim in the clear stream that ran through my village. Yes, he has full freedom to run in his village. Free to roast maize under the stars and ride the broad backs of slow-moving birds. Here, it is about his childhood days. How he spent it. As long as I obeyed my father and abided by the customs of my tribe, according to his tribe, he has to abide some, what do you call, customs, rules and regulations. I was not troubled by the law of man or God. Here, Nelson Mandela was not troubled by law or God. So this is the text from page number 109. So once again, dear children, Let's revise here the summary. The summary means till now what we read. Nelson Mandela's narration, "A Long Walk to Freedom," is at once self-stirring and thought-provoking. This narrative, which was written by Nelson Mandela, it was really thought-provoking. Thought-provoking means if we read it, we will get more and more thoughts in our minds. Every man has obligation to his family and his country. Yes, here already from the first lines we got it. In life, yes, in life, for every person, he has two obligations. The first obligation is to his family, and second obligation is to his country. These are must. Fulfilling them depends on one's ability and nature. Here, according to our nature, according to people's nature, according to the ability of people, here the fulfillment of these two obligations will be decided. But in South Africa, colored people were not allowed to fulfill any of those obligations. Here in South Africa, colored people means black people. Colored people were not allowed to fulfill these obligations. But he failed in the case of his family. Yes, Nelson Mandela was fully failed in his family. He was born free. Yes. Nelson Mandela was born free and free. But soon he discovered that his freedom was not true. Do you observe, my dears? First, he says that, yes, I am born free and free. I have freedom to play everywhere, in the nature, in the village. But later he is saying that freedom was not true. What freedom I have, that freedom was not true. And then he realized, no black in South Africa was free. Yes, here there is no freedom for black people. Yes, colored people. There was no freedom for colored people in South Africa. That is the what you call crucial racial discrimination among the people. They didn't have self-respect too. Yes, the colored people haven't self-respect to in South Africa. That is their what you call suppressed, crucial situation in South Africa. His hunger for personal freedom became the hunger for everyone's freedom. Yes, actually, every person has hunger for personal freedom. And in this context, it became as the freedom of what you call people's freedom. It is the freedom of everyone's, means it is the freedom of society. For that, he changed himself. Because of that, he changed himself, means he is changing his attitude. He became animated. Means animation means they're showing more and more. Even though if it is a little, it has to be shown more and more. Yes, here clearly Nelson Mandela has been writing his memories, and is a long walk to freedom. How did he spend his childhood days? And yet, in the first days, means in his first stage of life, according to his opinion, what is meant by freedom? And then he understood every person has two obligations in life. Here, the first one is, what is the first obligation for every person? Yes, the obligation towards, the obligation to his family. To his family means that is towards members of that family, to his father, to his mother, to his wife, to his children, like that. And second obligation, what children? What is second obligation? Yes, it's nothing but to his country, to his people, to his society. Yes. So how we have two eyes? How we have left and right eyes? We have two eyes. Like that, in that way, in the same way, every person, for every person in our life, we have two obligations. One is to his family and to his society. But according to Nelson Mandela, what he is saying, in South Africa, it's very hard to fulfill both two obligations. Why? Think of it. Why? Yes, there is discrimination of color. It's about racial discrimination or apartheid. Yes, I think this word is something new to you. Apartheid. What do you mean apartheid? It's nothing but a racial discrimination in South Africa. Yes, among the people of blackies and whiteies. So he was fully suppressed, and he came to know the freedom is not true. What he has, the freedom is not true. Yes, what he is enjoying, what the freedom he is enjoying, or which is the freedom he has, it's not true freedom. Yes, so because of that, he changed his attitudes, and he started his journey towards freedom, and he is getting ready to fight against that racial discrimination or apartheid. So my dear children, if we observe the text from the first page number 109. Yes, 109. If you observe the text of page number 109, the first word is, yes, let's know the meaning of new words. I mean, glossary. First one is inclination. Yes, do you observe? Yes. The word is inclination, means a feeling that makes a person to do something. Provoking. Yes, in other terms, provoking means a feeling that makes a person to do something. Suppose we are motivating you to listen to online classes very well and to note down the important points and to send feedback carefully. All we are trying to, yes, what we are doing? We are inclinating you. We are trying to motivate you. We are trying to provoke you to follow the online classes very well. And then next word, inevitably. Next word, inevitably. Yes, inevitably means certainly to happen and unable to be avoided or prevented. It is compulsory. There is no chance to escape. There is no chance to escape, or there is no chance to avoid. Inevitably. Yes, inevitably we have to follow online classes as it is a pandemic situation, because we haven't chance to interact in our physical classrooms. Yes, we must follow online classes to fulfill our loss. Inevitably, it's acting as an adverb. Inevitably, we are following. Yes, we are following online classes inevitably means compulsory, without avoiding, without escaping from these online classes. For example, for instance. And next word, DS, twilight. It's acting as an adjective. It's used to describe a way of life. It's used to describe a way of life which is characterized by uncertainty. Yeah, uncertainty means we can't expect or we can't speculate. We can't imagine what will be done, what will be happened in the future. Sometimes we can't expect, we can't imagine. So that is called twilightly. And then melai. Yeah, the word is acting as a noun. The word is acting as a noun. Here it's nothing but maize. Yes, corn. We are eating corn. Yes, we are eating corn. It's nothing but maize. It's nothing but maize. And another word, illusion. Illusion is acting as a noun. An idea or belief which is not true. It's